Welcome to this edition of Hoshizaki Technical Training. I'll be your host for this video, Mike Sprayberry. I'm with the Hoshizaki Technical Support Department. Today we'll be discussing the torque specs on a Flaker DCM gear motor evaporator assembly. So behind me is an F801 Flaker. It has a 70 millimeter evaporator gear motor assembly. The unit you have may have a 45 millimeter, it may have a 70 millimeter, it may have a 90 millimeter. Now, depending upon where the fasteners are used, that will depend upon your torque spec. If you'll want to reference your torque specs on Service Bulletin SB10-0005 Revision 6. The four different locations we're going to be looking at torque specs are going to be the bolts that hold the gear motor housing to the gear motor, the socket head cap screws that hold the evaporator to the gear motor housing, the socket head cap screws or seal bolts that hold the extruding head into the evaporator, and also the torque spec on your cutter head. So for a proper illustration, we have removed the gear motor evaporator assembly from a unit to kind of show you better what bolts we're going to torque. So to start out with, make sure you have your torque wrench set on the proper torque. And just so you know that the torque specifications on the service bulletin are in Newton meters and foot pounds. So if you have a torque wrench, you either convert it one way or the other, or just use the spec on the service bulletin. So when you take it apart, remember how everything went. For example, this gear motor housing has to be clocked properly. So just kind of make a mental note or take a picture of it with your cell phone, so when you put it back together, you have it clocked the same. So we'll start by putting the coupling spline back in, the gear motor housing, where we're going to start. And again, whenever you go to retorque, you need to look at the thread size of the bolts to go to your gear motor housing and use the spec sheet torque to properly torque them down to the proper specification. And just a note about your torque wrench, when they're not being used, make sure you set the setting down to zero. So you'll look at your spec sheet, see what your torque value is for these specific bolts. You'll want to set your torque value on your torque wrench to what it says on the spec sheet. Get your proper socket to fit the bolt head. And you want to tighten it. Kind of hold your torque wrench out toward the end. Don't choke up on it, but hold it out toward the end. Give you proper leverage. When it clicks, go to the one across from it. When it clicks, go to the one next to it. Going clockwise. When it clicks, go to the one across from it. Going clockwise again, the one next to it. Clicks, one across from it. And all six of these bolts should be torqued. You may want to give it another round just to be sure. When it clicks, across from it. Clicks, next to it. Clicks, the one across from it. Click, again next to it. Click across from it. So now we know all these are torqued down to the torque value that we have dialed up on the torque wrench. So now we'll put our auger in. You want to put your bolts in the evaporator that holds the evaporator to the gear motor housing. Torque those. Consult the service bulletin for the proper torque spec of the unit that you have and the size of evaporator that you have. Grab and head socket. Set the torque wrench to the torque value on the torque sheet or the spec sheet. Click, there's one on the opposite side. Click, and then when they're all tightened down, go over one more time. So where you started from, across from it, next to it, and the last one across from it. And that's the socket head cap screws that hold in the evaporator to the gear motor housing. Now for the next part. All right, next is gonna be the extruding head. So your extruding head uses seal bolts to hold it to the evaporator. These are a one-time use seal bolt. So if you've taken them out, you'll need to get new ones and put them back in. You'll also need to use some Loctite 243, medium strength. This is not permanent Loctite, but you need to put a generous amount of Loctite on the seal bolts before you install them. You also notice we've also removed the drip pan and the flange for better visibility of what we're trying to do here today. Again, generous amount of Loctite. Look at your spec sheet or the service bulletin for the proper amount of torque for the size seal bolts you're putting in the extruding head. You want to set your torque wrench to that torque. Clicks. And very important on the extruding heads, these definitely have to be torqued twice, so go back to where you started from. One more round to the clicks. 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 And clicks. Then your final fastener, or the final thing you want to torque down. Now this is a cubelet cutter head, but it still needs to be torqued. You may have a flaker cutter head. It's just basically a flaker cutter head that has the actual loose bolt that goes through the cutter, but this is a cubelet cutter head, so it's all made as one assembly. So you want to screw it into place as far as you can by hand. Check the torque spec on the service bulletin or spec sheet, and adjust the torque where it needs to be. Click, and do it one more time. Click. And that's all there is to it. Thank you for joining us today for this technical training video of the Flaker DCM gear motor evaporator assembly fastener torque. If you have any questions, just contact us at Hoshizaki Tech Support.